Hello friends, today I am presenting you current affairs and newspaper updates from 17th of September to 23rd of September 2017. Watch many videos on many topics on my channel VIJAY ANAND Master Mix. And in the beginning I would like to request you to please like it, share it and subscribe the channel. I have classified the video in following topics like international, national, defense issue, economy and business, persons in news, then in places in news, awards, books and sports. Beginning with international news first. Bjarni Benediktsson, who is a prime minister of Iceland, has resigned because his party was independent party. And Bright Future Party has withdrawn the support from the coalition government there. International Day for Preservation of Ozone Layer was on September the 16th. International Day of Democracy was on September the 15th. Hurricane Maria hit Dominican Republic. Kurdish Indonesia government has decided that they will go through a referendum on September the 25th. The leader is Masoud Barzani. They are demanding a Kurdistan, which is a Kurdistan regional government, and want to make Erbil as the capital. Kurdistan is an area which covers area of Turkey, Syria, Iran, and then Iraq. They are claiming that a separate country should be made for Kurds. That is why Iraq is opposing it, because Erbil is in Iraq. Side by side, Turkish army has also said that they will also oppose this idea. Prime Minister of Iraq is Haider al-Abadi. Iraqi Prime Minister has said that the referendum is illegal. Earthquake of 7.1 Richter scale hit Mexico, in which 225 people die. Switching to national news now. Google has started a payment app. Its name is Tez. Prime Minister opened Narmada Dam project, which is in Kevadia in Gujarat. It is world's second biggest dam after Grand Coulee Dam of USA. Dam is 138.68 meter high, 1200 meters long, and 163 meter depth. Chakmas will not get Indian citizenship. Previously, government was saying that Chakmas and Hajong will get Indian citizenship. Now, Chakma Buddhist, who fled from Bangladesh, then East Pakistan in 1960, will not get Indian citizenship as per the government. First state to implement Family Welfare District Committee is Tripura. They are doing it to aware people about family planning and also of welfare of family. 1756 crore rupees has been sanctioned for Khelo India, which is a project of Government of India for development of sports in country. They have allotted it for 3 years. Pension Adalat has been started by Government of India. It will resolve issues and grievances related to pension for the public. India's first electric bus services started between Manali and Rohtang Pass in Himachal Pradesh. Newton is India's entry to Oscars. It is going in the category of best foreign language film. Director of the movie Newton is Amit Masurkar and producer is Manish Mundra. For early prevention of cancer in female, government have started a program called Nurturing the Nurturer. Moving on to defense issues now. Navy's patrol aircraft TU-142M, which is not in service now, will be turned into a museum. It will be placed at Visakhapatnam, and from September the 27th, it will open to public. Joint Base Lewis-McCord was the venue for military exercise of USA and India. Navy took delivery of Kalveri. It is the first of the Scorpion marine submarine which has been made after the technological transfer from DCNS, which is a French company. Moving on to economy and business news now. Trinetra Cements Limited and Trishul Concrete Products Limited have merged with India Cements. Mahindra and Mahindra has bought Erkunt Tractor Sanayi AS, which is a company of Turkey. Amount has not been disclosed. India and Russia together will build nuclear power plant at Rupur in Bangladesh. Vistadome coaches will be come into effect. It will start by putting into service between Dadar and Madgaon Jan Shatabdi Express for public. It will open from September the 18th. Vistadome coaches are the coaches which has large glass windows and glass ceilings for public to give a good view of the surroundings. It will enhance tourism because of the views that is available for the passengers. Seats are 180 degree revolving and also LEDs will be given to the passengers. The services Vistadome coaches were first installed in Visakhapatnam Kirundul passenger express in April this year. Some persons in news. Marshal of Indian Air Force Arjan Singh died at age of 98 years. He was the only 5-star rank officer of India. He was born at Lailpur, which was in Pakistan, in East, I should say, in Pakistan. It is also now known as Faisalabad. Harry Dean Stanton was a Hollywood character actor. He died at age of 91 years. Bob Holland, who played cricket for Australia, died at the age of 70 years. Mohammad Asliyumuddin, who was MP of RJD from Araria in Bihar, died at age of 74 years. Chand Nath Yogi, who was MP from BJP from Alwar, died at age of 61 years. YC Modi is the new Director General of NIA. Full form of NIA is National Investigation Agency. Kartik Chandra Paine, who was a painter of India, died at age of 86 years. He was Kolkata-based painter. Mercedes Araoz is a new Prime Minister of Peru. He defeated and also replaced present Prime Minister Fernando Zavala. Stanislas Petrov, upon whom a documentary was made, The Man Who Saved the World. He was a Russian officer, died at age of 77 years. When he was serving, a missile was about to hit Russia, but he didn't inform Russian authorities and saved the world. Because if he had informed, then Russia and America would have entangled into a war that could have led loss of a lot of life and property. Jack LaMotta, who was a US boxer, died at age of 95 years. B. Sambamurthy has become chairman of National Payment Corporation of India. Shakila, who was a Bollywood actress, died at age of 82 years. Her memorable roles were in movie CID and Arpar. Balraj Joshi has become chairman of NHPC, National Hydro Power Corporation. Liliane Bethencourt of France, who was owner of L'Oreal. Also, it has brands like Maybelline and Garnier, who was world's richest woman, 14th overall, died at the age of 94 years. Her total asset was $39.5 billion. Some places in news. EU and India summit will be held at Delhi in October 9-10. 36 national games will be held in Goa in November 2017. Dahej in Gujarat, there India's first central institute of chemical engineering and technology will be set up. 6th International Textile and Apparel Fair, which name was Vastra, held at Jaipur from 21st to 24th of September. Some awards. Zannaha Mustafa of Nigeria won UNHCR Nansen Refugee Award. Full form is United Nations High Commission for Refugee Award. He has worked a lot for refugees about their education and healthcare there in Nigeria. Survivor of Boko Haram. Jawaharlal Nehru Port Trust of Mumbai has won Raj Bhasha Kirti Award for extensive use of Hindi. Important books released this week. India Priorities for the Future. The book has been written by Bimal Janan, former governor of Reserve Bank of India. No Room for Small Dreams is the book written by Shimon Peres, who hold virtually every position in politics of Israel, from president downwards to defense minister, etc., etc. What Happened is the book written by Hillary Clinton. Barefoot to Boots, The Many Lives of Indian Football. It's the story of Indian football. Has been written by legendary commentator and author Novi Kapadia. Evolving with Subramanyam Swami, A Rural Coastal Ride. The book has been written by Roxana Swami. Some sports news now. Vishakhapatnam was the venue for 4th Indian Open World Ranking Snooker Tournament. And there in the final, John Higgins defeated Anthony McGill. Both players are from Scotland. Singapore Formula 1 Grand Prix won by Lewis Hamilton. Daniel Ricciardo came second and Valtteri Bottas came third. Hamilton and Valtteri Bottas drive cars of Mercedes and Ricciardo drive car of Red Bull. ITTF Asian Cup Table Tennis Cup, and there in the final, in the men section, Lin Gao Yuan won the title. For female, Zhu Yilun of won the title, and they both players were from China. West Indies defeated England in one of T20 match. Man of the match was Sunil Narayan. Korea Open Super Series badminton title held at Seoul, and there in the final, Anthony Sinisuka Ginting of Indonesia won men's title. And in female final, PV Sindhu of India defeated Nozomi Okuhara of Japan and took revenge of her defeat at Glasgow in World Badminton Championship. European basketball title held at Istanbul in Turkey, and there Slovenia defeated Serbia in the final. Spain came third. Watch many videos on many topics on my channel VIJAY ANAND Master Mix. Go to playlist and enjoy videos. Please like it, share it among your friends and subscribe the channel. Thank you very much.